بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I welcome you again to a new episode of Major Sins in Islam. And today, inshallah, we'll be talking about a major sin in Islam that many Muslims, especially wives, especially Muslim females, belittle. They think it is not a major sin, it is not a matter that I should be concerned about. When the reality, after you hear what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger had mentioned about a wife disobeying her husband, you realize that this is no doubt a severe and a major matter. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that any woman in which her husband will call her to bed and she will refuse or reject, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, the one in the heavens will curse her. Not only that, there's another narrations in which the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam says that the animals and the fish will curse this woman as long as her husband is upset or angry from her, until her husband is pleased from her, until she repents. My sister in Islam, I speak to every single wife out there. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, and fear Allah azza wa jal within your husbands. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, any woman, any wife, that her husband passes away, and her husband was pleased from her, she will enter the paradise. She will enter the paradise. Yes, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is connected to the pleasure of your husband. Pleasing your husband is a form of pleasing Allah azza wa jal. Displeasing your husband is a form of displeasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, he says, alayhi salatu wa salam, in this famous hadith, that any woman in which she prays, her daily prayers, she fasts the month of Ramadan, and she obeys her husband, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell her to enter the paradise from any gate she wishes. Amazing. Amazing to the wives in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made a way for them to enter the paradise. He says alayhi salatu wasalam, any woman that prays her five daily prayers, fasts her Ramadan or the month of Ramadan, and she obeys her husband, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell her to enter the paradise from any gate of the paradise she wishes. All this just by your obedience to your husband. Obtain the pleasure of your husband. Don't think if your husband is upset from you, it does not matter. And if he's upset and he's angry from you, it is something that's normal. No. When your husband is angry from you, know at that moment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also angry from you. And when your husband is upset from you, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased from you. Don't take this matter lightly. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was approached by a woman, and she was complaining to her. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, she was complaining to him about her husband. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, do you know that through him you'll enter the paradise? Do you know that through him, through your husband, you'll enter the paradise? I say to all the wives and I say to all the sisters who are married, you know through your husband, it is your way to enter the paradise. Through your husband is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should be cautious. The way you are cautious, the way you deal with your mother and your father, your parents, you should also be cautious. On the second category, on the second priority, is also to be cautious what you say and how you speak to your husband and how you deal with them. Alayhi salatu wasalam was once approached by a female, by one of the sahabiyat, in which she came to speak on the behalf of a delegation, on the behalf of other Muslim females, of other Muslim companion females. And she said to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that I'm coming here speaking on the behalf of a group of females, and we were wondering that the men always are in front of us when they come in regards of pleasing Allah Azza wa Jal. The men can do things that we can't do. They attend the jama'ah, they're always around you, and they also go out in the jihad. Us women, we don't get this opportunity. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, and listen carefully to this, alayhi salatu wa sallam told this woman to go back to the woman that she came on their behalf, and to tell them that one of you, through the pleasure of their husband, through the service of their husband, through looking after their husband, is equivalent to all that you've mentioned. The wife, the woman, through her looking after her husband and the needs of her husband and taking care of her husband, is equivalent to all those things that this woman had mentioned about praying with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, even fighting in the path of Allah azza wa jal, even in the jihad. Yes, my sister in Islam, remember that when you look after the needs of your husband, you respect your husband, you bring happiness into the heart of your husband, you are on the same level if not even more, of someone who's fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that there are three types of people that Allah azza wa jalla would not accept their prayers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not even elevate a hasana to them. And Allah Azza wa Jal would not even elevate a hasana for them to the heavens. And amongst them is a woman in which her husband is displeased from her. Yes, a woman that her husband is displeased from her. You as a wife, if your husband is displeased from you and he's angry from you, know that when you pray, you're not getting in a hasanat. Not I'm saying that your prayer is not accepted. Your prayer is accepted as a fard, but you're not getting in a hasanat for that prayer. For the good that you do, you're not getting in a hasanat for it. Look how much Islam really cares about the duty and the responsibility of this female towards her husband. In some areas where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the female, she is not allowed to fast a voluntarily fasting until she seeks the permission of her husband. You know, you might think and say, but my worship to Allah azza wa jalla is a lot more important. But the worship of Allah is connected through the pleasure of your husband. The worship of Allah and the pleasure of Allah is connected through you serving the needs of your husband. That's why when the husband calls the wife to the bed and she refuses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will curse her. And Allah azza wa jal, in some narrations, the sun and the moon and the animals and the fish and everyone and the angels will curse this woman until she repents and or until her husband is pleased from her. See how big this sin is? Where are the wives of the Muslims these days? They treat their husbands worse than what they treat their children. They treat their husbands as like some stranger. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam warns of that. And he sends so many warnings amongst those women who neglect the rights of their husbands and those women who do not treat their husbands in a way that pleases Allah azza wa jal. Yes, you do not obey your husband when it comes to disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا طَاعَةَ لِمَخْلُوقٍ فِي مَعْصِيَةِ الْخَالِقِ. We do not obey the creation to disobey the creator. When it comes to the obedience of Allah Azza wa Jal, when it comes to the fard, yes, the obedience of Allah and the fard have more priority than obeying the husband. But in return, we should be respectful to the husband. We should speak in a nice way. We should speak in a nice matter, in a nice manner. You know, it really surprises me sometimes where you find that this husband and wife were to be the most beloved one to each other and the most closest one to each other. And then when they dispute, or then when they break up, they become the worst of enemies towards one another. They become the worst of enemies towards each other. What kind of a marriage is that? And in return, we do say to the husbands not to take advantage or to abuse the authority that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him. Not to misuse what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him from the rights of the wife upon him or his rights upon his wife. The husband should have hikmah in dealing with the wife. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. The best of you are those best to their families, and I am the best to my family. Some husbands take advantage of them having the authority and them having that respect in the household. They take advantage of the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Allah would never be pleased from a woman until the husband is pleased from her. So he starts to be slave the wife, and this is wrong. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the best of husbands to his wives. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was the best of men to his woman. This is the character of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and this is the character that we should adopt. This is the character that we should be following. Not just to take advantage of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given me over my wife and be slave my wife or treat her in a wrong way or mistreatment. She is a trust in my hands. She is a trust around my neck that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had entrusted you with. So it should be in a balance. The household should be balanced, where the husband is balanced with the way he treats his wife, and the wife should be also balanced and obedient to her husband, and not to let the shaitan come in between. Because one of the major things that shaitan works so hard is always to split between a couple, always to split between the husband and wife. Because husband and wife, this is a settlement. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran al-Kareem, that we had made from amongst your partners, لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا, so you could settle between one another. Because marriage is a protection. Marriage is a way to get closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever gets married had fulfilled half of the portion of Islam. Let them fear Allah Azza wa Jal in the second portion or the second half. So marriage is a form of getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why shaitan comes to break between the couples. Because once he breaks between them, that will lead them to Allah of Haram. There's a famous story of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when one of the companions or one of the believers came to complain to him about the attitude of his wife towards him. So when he arrived near the house and the door of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he heard the wife of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu screaming at Umar and telling Umar off and shouting at Umar. So when he heard that, he knocked once and he walked away. He said, what's the point for me coming to someone who, in which I want him to help me and he needs help himself? So when Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu opened the door, he saw this man walking away. So he called him. He said, are you the one that knocked on my door? So he said, yes. He said, what do you want from me? He said that I came to you to complain to you about the attitude of my wife, but I heard the attitude of your wife towards you. So I said, how can someone help me when they need help themselves? So Umar said, yes, maybe my wife, sometimes she screams and shouts at me, but I do not forget that she is the one that cooks my food, and she is the one that bakes my bread, and she is the one that cleans my clothes, and she is the one that looks after my children, and she is the one that fulfills my desire. Shouldn't I have patience on that? Yes, shouldn't you have patience on that? And I say that to both wife and husband, that even that you see something wrong from your wife, and even that you see something wrong from your husband, have patience. If you see one bad thing, alhamdulillah, you could see another 10 good things from him or her, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam taught us. Therefore, my brother and my sister, let us fear Allah azza wa jal with my wife, and let me fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with my husband. Your husband, as you being a Muslima, as you being a wife, your husband, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made his pleasure through his pleasure. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says that any woman in which her husband passes away and he is pleased from her, she'll enter the paradise. He is your way to enter the paradise. He is your path to enter the paradise. So have patience on him, even though you might hear or see or experience something that you missed, you don't like, or something that you don't want. But at the end of the day, for the sake of Allah, you should have patience. Have patience that at the end of the day, maybe this is your way to get closer to Allah. Maybe this is the way that you could get a higher place in the paradise. And same thing to the husbands. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what Allah azza wa jal had entrusted you with from your wives. Your wives are a trust, a amana, a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which Allah had entrusted you with before her father or before her brother or before her uncle had entrusted you with. This is a trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from his last recommendations before his death, he said, fear Allah and what Allah azza wa jal had entrusted you with from your wives, from your females, from the women that Allah had entrusted you with. So I'll remind you again, be dutiful towards one another. As a wife, I must be dutiful and respectful to my husband, because he is my way to get closer to Allah. He is my way to please Allah. And if I'm not, then this is a way in which Allah will curse me, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be displeased from me, and Allah azza wa jal would never accept a good deed from me, and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make me enter the paradise. So think about that, and don't take that as a little or belittle this matter. This is a major matter. This is a major issue that many Muslims neglect. So I do remind you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be dutiful towards your husband. Do not disrespect your husband. Do not mistreat your husband. Do not look down on your husband. He is your way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is your way to the Jannah, and he is your way to the pleasure of Allah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who listen and hear, act upon what they listen and hear. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك